What if your business had a 24/7 employee who never takes breaks, replies to emails instantly, and can actually think on its feet? Hi, I'm Kevin, and in this video, I'll show you how you can build your own AI agent using Make, no coding required, and it's free to get started. At the Kevin Cookie Company, we get tons of email about cookie flavors, store hours, pricing, and more. Rather than replying to each message manually, let's have our AI agent take care of it instantly and also politely. If you'd like to follow along and build your own AI agent, head to the address at the bottom of the screen. That link will take you to the free signup page. This link gives you a free account plus 1 month of complimentary access to the Pro plan with 10,000 operations and additional premium features included. I partnered with Make to walk you through exactly how it works, step by step. Let's dive in. Once you finish signing in, you'll land here on the main Make dashboard. Head over to the left-hand side and click on AI Agents. Then, in the center of the screen or in the top right-hand corner, let's click on Create Agent. This opens up a prompt where we can create our AI agent. But before we can do that, we need to establish a connection with an AI model. That's something that's going to understand and reason over the input that we send to our agent. When I click on this, we need to choose a connection type, and we have all sorts of different providers of various AI models. You'll probably recognize some of these names. As an example, we have OpenAI, Anthropic, Mistral, and the list goes on and on. In this video, I'll be using Grok. The reason why is it lets us run some of the best open source models, like Meta's brand new Llama 3. And it also happens to be completely free and also unbelievably fast. I'll select Grok. Next, we need to choose a connection name. I'll leave this set to the default of my Grok connection. And down below, you need to enter in your API key. I'll paste mine in. If you don't have an API key, let me show you briefly how you can get that. Head to the website grok.com, and in the top right-hand corner, let's click on Dev Console. And right here, sign up for a free account. Once you finish signing in, right here at the top of the screen, let's click on the button that says Create API Key. And right at the very top, you'll see your API key, and right over here, you can click on this button to copy it. Back within Make, paste in your API key, and then let's click on Save. Over here, we need to give our agent a name. My agent is going to respond to customer questions, in which case, I think customer service agent works very well. Next, we need to choose a model. Grok gives us access to several versions of Meta's Llama 3, including the faster and also smaller models like 3.8b. And you also get access to more powerful ones like Llama 3.70b, which is better at understanding complex inputs. For most cases, the 70b versatile is a great all-around choice. It balances speed and quality, and it also works well for things like writing responses, summarizing messages, and also making decisions. I'll choose this model right here. Down at the bottom, we need to enter in a system prompt, and this is one of the most important steps of setting up your AI agent. Think of this as the agent's internal job description. It tells the AI who it is, what it should do, and also how it should respond. Here, I'll enter in my prompt. Now, this is a friendly and helpful customer service agent for the Kevin Cookie Company. Respond to customer questions about things like cookie flavors, store hours, shipping, and pricing. Keep your tone warm, polite, professional, like you're talking to a real customer. Answer clearly and concisely. And also, if it can't answer a question, let the customer know and suggest contacting support. This helps guide the AI so it stays on track and responds the way you want, whether that's casual or fun, or super professional and structured. You can decide. Once you enter in your system prompt in the bottom right-hand corner, let's click on Save. And that's it. Now that we've added our system prompt, we've officially created our AI agent. Nice work. It now understands its role and it's ready to get to work. Of course, like any good employee, it also needs the right tools to do its job well. For example, we'll need to give it access to information about the cookies we offer, the pricing, and other common questions. Right down here at the bottom, we have system tools and we can add some. I'll click on this, but you'll notice that we don't yet have any tools. So let's close out of this view. To add new tools, over on the left-hand side, let's jump into scenarios. I'll click on this. In the top right-hand corner, let's click on Create a New Scenario. This takes us into the visual scenario designer. In my case, I want to provide the agent with our FAQ, and that happens to be stored in a Google Doc. Let's have a quick look. Here I am in Google Docs, and this document contains all of the most frequently asked questions here at the Kevin Cookie Company. As an example, what cookie flavors do you offer? And then we have a list. How much do your cookies cost? What are your retail store hours? Where are you located? And we have lots of other questions that we answer here. I want my agent to have access to all of this information to help it with answering customer questions. Let's now go back to Make. Back here within the scenario designer, to give our AI agent access to the FAQ, we need to connect it to Google Docs. Right here in the center of the screen, let's click on this plus icon to add what's called a module. To the right, you'll notice that you can connect to thousands of other apps. Google Docs is just one example. It happens to be where I have my FAQ, but maybe you have your data stored within Google Sheets. Maybe you have it on a website. If I scroll down a little bit more, you could also pull data from Notion, different CRMs, databases, and more. You could pull in whatever data your agent needs. Now, I happen to have my data in Google Docs and I see it right here. So I'll click on Google Docs. You can also define how you want to interact with Google Docs, and we have lots of different options. I simply want to get the content of the document and provide that and make it available to my agent. So right here, I'll click on Get Content of a Document. The first time you use Google Docs in Make, you'll need to create a connection right up on top. Simply click on Add, choose your Google account, and then you could grant access. Once you're connected, you'll need to pick the document that contains your content. Now, right here, we could choose by mapping, in which case you need to enter in the document ID. Or alternatively, I could also choose by dropdown, and here I can navigate to where I have that file in my Drive account. So right here, I'll click on this dropdown, and this will pull up a list of all of my different documents. At the very top, I see my FAQ. I'll choose this document. Then down at the bottom, let's click on Save. Now that we've pulled in content from our Google Doc, we need to send that information back to the AI agent. To do that, we're going to add one more module. So let's click on this plus icon and right up on top, search for a module called Scenarios. Here we have a few different options and we want to return output. This tells Make what data should be passed along as the tool the agent can use. I'll click on this. Here it tells us that we need to add scenario outputs. Let's click on this. Right down below, we can define the output structure. Let's click on Add Item. Right up on top, we can give it a name. I'll call it KCC underscore FAQ. Then I could also enter in a description. This is the Kevin Cookie Company FAQ. The type is text. And right down below, let's now click on Save. Let's now click on the Scenarios module. And right here, let's click into this text field. And now we have to choose what information from the Google Doc should be sent back as output. I'd like to send all of the text content of the document. I'll click on this. And then we could click on Save. We can now test it out to make sure that we're able to retrieve all of the data from the Google Doc and that it shows up as output. So right down in the bottom left-hand corner, let's click on Run Once. Right up on top, I can see that this consumed two operations, one to read the Google Doc and another one to provide the output. Let's click on this icon right here, and then we can see all the output. And there I see my FAQ is now successfully being retrieved and provided as output. Let's close out of this. In the top left-hand corner, let's give this scenario or this tool a better name. I'll click over here and let's remove this. And in place of that, I'll type in the Kevin Cookie Company FAQ. Then down at the very bottom, let's click on the save icon. The last step is to schedule when this scenario should run. Currently it's set to every 15 minutes. Let's click on this. We want our agent to be able to query this information when it needs it. So let's click on this dropdown. We have all sorts of different options. Let's select on demand and then let's click on save. Next, let's click on activate scenario. Then in the bottom left-hand corner, let's save it again. Now that the scenario is ready, we can add it as a tool that the AI agent can use. Over on the left-hand side, let's go back to AI agents. Back within AI agents, you should see the agents that we created earlier. Right over here, let's click on the configure button. And down at the bottom, we have system tools. Let's click on add. On this screen, you should see the scenario that we just added. Here's the Kevin Cookie Company FAQ. Now it says that I need to add a scenario description. Let's click on add description. And right down here, I'll type in my description. It retrieves the Kevin Cookie Company's FAQ from a Google Doc. And then I also have a little bit of information about what it'll find within that document. Now keep in mind, this is very important. It lets the agent understand how to use this scenario. Once you finish entering in your description, let's click on save. Over on the right-hand side, make sure to check this box and then let's click on add. And that's now added it as one of the tools that this AI agent can leverage. In the top right-hand corner, let's now click on save. I'd also like this agent to be able to email customers. We need to add another tool to be able to do that. So just like we did before, over on the left-hand side, let's click into the scenarios view. In the top right-hand corner, let's click on create a new scenario. For the AI agent to be able to send an email, it needs to provide three different pieces of input: the customer's email address, the subject of the email, and also the content or the body of the email. Without these, we won't be able to send an email. Down at the very bottom, we need to define these different pieces of input. Let's click on this icon, and right here we have a category for scenario inputs. We're going to add those three. First, let's add an item, and right at the very top, we'll call this one the customer email address. We could leave all these other settings as is. Then down at the bottom, let's add another item. For this one, let's call this the email subject, go down to the bottom, and for the final one, we're going to add the email content. Once you finish filling in those three different pieces of input, let's click on save. Now that we have those three pieces of input, we can now send an email. To do that, we're going to add a module. Click on the plus icon, and here we see all the different apps that we could connect to. Search for your email platform. Maybe you use Gmail or Outlook. In my case, I'll simply search for email, and I see the option to send an email. I will select this. If this is your first time connecting to your email provider, you'll have to establish a connection right up on top. Next, we want to map all of the input from the AI agent to the different fields on the email. Let's start with the to field. I'll click here and then click into this text field. Up on top, let's click on this icon, and here we can see all those different scenario inputs that we just defined. This is the customer email address. I'll select this. Then here we could define the subject or map the subject. I'll click in this field. Let's click up on top. And here I see the email subject. And right here, I see the content type and the content. Let's click on content right up on top. Let's click here. And I'll click on email content. This way, all of the different input from the AI agent will be filled into an email message. Once you finish mapping all of these different fields, down in the bottom right-hand corner, let's click on save. Let's now give this scenario a better name. In the top left-hand corner, let's select this, remove that text, and I'll enter in send email replies to customers. Once you type in the new name down at the bottom, let's now save it. Next, let's set the interval for when this should run. We want the AI agent to be able to run this when it wants to send an email, or basically on demand. Right up on top, let's click on this dropdown and then select on demand and then click on save. And let's also activate the scenario. Down at the bottom, let's now save this. Now that we've finished building the email tool, let's bring it all together. Let's set it up so that the agent can read different customer questions and then email a response. Over on the left-hand side, once again, let's click into scenarios. Right here, we can see the two tools that we've already built. In the top right, let's click on create a new scenario. Now it's time to build out our AI agent so it can respond to new question submissions automatically. We receive our customer questions through Tally. If you've never heard of it, it's a simple form builder, kind of like Google Forms. So here in the all apps list, I'll search for Tally. And right here, I see two different options: watch for new responses or list field definitions. I want to watch for new responses. I'll click on this. Here's a quick look at what our Tally form looks like. It's really simple. We ask for their name, their email address, and their question. And coming soon, they'll get an automated response by AI. Next, I need to establish the connection. Over here, I'll choose the hook, my new response webhook. I'll select that. And down below, I'll click on save. Once a customer question comes in on our form, we want our AI agents to read the question, refer to the FAQ, and then also compose a response and send it back via email. To do that, we need to add another module. Let's click on this plus icon, and here we have all the different apps again. Search for one called Make AI Agents. I'll click on this. And right here, we have the option to run an agent. I'll select that. Right up on top, let's choose the agent that we would like to use to respond to all of these customer questions on that form. I'll click on this dropdown, and there we have that customer service agent that we set up together. I'll select this. Down below, you'll see agent level tools. These are tools that the agent always has access to, no matter which scenario it's used in. Think of them as global tools. In this scenario, our customer service agent always has access to the FAQ since it's relevant across multiple scenarios. You'll notice though that the email tool does not appear here. So what happened to it? That's because I did not assign it as an agent level tool. Instead, I'd like it to be a scenario specific tool since in this particular scenario, the agent needs to respond to customer questions by email. Right down here, let's click on Add Tools. In this dropdown, let's select our email tool. I'll pick this one, and we could also enter in a description. That way, the AI agent knows when to use this tool. Down below, let's click on Add. Now, let's say that I wanted to use this customer service agent to respond to customer WhatsApp messages instead. I could reuse this same agent, but instead of assigning the email tool, instead I could use a WhatsApp tool in that specific scenario. Hopefully that helps clarify when to use an agent level tool versus a scenario specific tool. If we scroll down a little bit more, we have another section for additional system instructions. This is where we can give the AI a little bit of extra information to make its replies more personal. Let's add some additional information. Greet the customer by name and sign off with Cheers, Kevin Cookie Company Customer Support. Now, instead of just saying greet the customer by name, why don't we actually feed in the customer's name? I'll remove name, and over on the right-hand side, I can see all the different fields that come back from that tally form that the customer submits. And right here, I see a section with fields, and I see your name. I'll select that and insert it into these custom instructions for the agent. Let's touch up the text over here. Let's actually specify that this is their name. Right down below, we can also specify the prompt that we're going to send to the AI. Let's click on Add Item. Let's click into message one, and then I'll type in the prompt. I want to feed in the customer name, their question, their email address, and then ask the AI to respond to this question. So for the customer name, let's feed that in from the tally form. Right over here, I'll insert the name. Then let's insert their question. Right here, I see a field for question. I'll insert that. Then we also have the customer email address. Let's do the same. Let's put in the customer email address, and then can you respond to this question? And I'll also throw in via email. Down at the very bottom, let's now click on Save. And let's click on Save once more. Over in the bottom left-hand corner, let's now test it out by running it. I'll click on this. Here in Tally, I'll fill out a new form response. It looks like Cookie Monster has a question. I'll enter in his email address and his question. It looks like he wants to know the store hours on Saturday. Let's submit that. And here we have an email response written by our AI agent. Hello, Cookie Monster. According to our FAQ, our store hours on Saturday are from 10 to 6 p.m. We hope this helps you and look forward to seeing you soon. Cheers, Kevin Cookie Company Customer Support. Exactly what I expected. Back within Make, we can see that it successfully ran. In the bottom left-hand corner, I can now turn it on so anytime a customer submits a question, the AI agent will automatically respond. Although we used Tally and email in this specific example, one of the best things about Make is how flexible it is. You're not limited to just a few tools. You can use any of the thousands of supported apps to fit your specific workflow. You can completely customize how your AI agent fits into your business, whether it's for support, marketing, operations, or really anything else. And that's how you can use Make to build an AI agent that replies to customer messages automatically and in real time. Again, if you want to try it for yourself, head to make.kevinstratvert.com and you can get started for free. Please consider subscribing and I'll see you in the next video.